It's bad that China is trying to copy SpaceX's Raptor 3 engine. These two engines may seem similar because they both look like SpaceX's Raptor 3, but they are actually different. One is the original Raptor 3, and the other is a copy made in China. China has copied SpaceX's rocket and launch tower. Now they are trying to make SpaceX's most powerful engine to use in a new hybrid rocket that combines components from their current rockets. How closely has China copied the Raptor engine? Can it really compete with SpaceX? Let's discuss all of this in today's episode of NR Study. When it comes to China, we know they are very good at copying designs and technology very accurately. SpaceX is the leader in building rockets today, so many others are trying to copy them. China often takes ideas from SpaceX's developments, using them for rockets, launch towers, and now engines. The first image in this discussion shows that SpaceX's Raptor 3 engine has been copied. The shiny black Raptor 3 is SpaceX's latest engine model. This engine is currently in production and will soon be used to power Starship V3, which is due to launch in a few months. This engine was designed to replace the Raptor 2, providing more thrust with a much simpler design. This simplicity makes manufacturing more efficient and also helps with operation, upgrades, and reuse. In short, it's a highly sophisticated engine designed to help humans reach Mars. But now this same design has appeared in other parts of the world. This replica in China is called Mammoth 1 and is made by a company called Star Shuttle Technology. Interestingly, in some online updates and on the rocket's branding, the company appears to be using the name ARCT. This is likely a new company, as not many people are familiar with it. The name of the engine is significant because Mammoth 1 suggests that there may be more versions or even different types of engines coming in the future. SpaceX is always coming up with new ideas, and it seems the company wants to keep up with those changes little by little. The most striking thing about the Mammoth 1 is its exterior. At first glance, it looks very similar to SpaceX's Raptor 3, from the nozzle to the intricate pipes on top. What's even more surprising is that the company isn't just copying the overall shape, but also the simplification SpaceX made on the Raptor 3. Similar to SpaceX, this Chinese-made design is small and sleek, with only 3 or 4 large, easily visible tubes, while the smaller parts are hidden.
This shows just how ambitious it is. Its vacuum thrust hasn't been officially announced, but estimates suggest it's between 260 and 270 tons. The engine has an efficiency time of 330 seconds. While this isn't as good as the Raptor 2 and 3, it's still a strong competitor compared to most engines currently in use. All signs point to the Mammoth 1 using a full-flow staged combustion cycle, similar to the Raptor. The propellant used also matches SpaceX's design, using liquid methane and liquid oxygen. Star Shuttle Technology says the Mammoth 1 completed a system plan review in the first half of this year, indicating progress in its development. The company plans to test components and conduct ignition trials before the end of the year. If all goes well, the engine could be ready for use by 2026. However, the imitation doesn't end with the engine. Next to the Mammoth 1, there's another replica of the launch vehicle. This rocket is called Glacier 1. Just like the engine, the name suggests there could be a new version in the future. Again, the design looks very similar. In fact, the Glacier 1 looks like a mix of several rockets. The first stage is very similar to Falcon 9 boosters. It has the same length, rugged fins, and foldable legs for landing. These features suggest that Star Shuttle Technology plans to land and reuse the first stage, perhaps using a drone ship in the ocean. The rocket is reportedly made of stainless steel, just like Starship. If we look up, we can see a hot staging system placed between the stages. This is very similar to the one SpaceX uses for Starship V3. The idea of hot staging, where the upper stage engine begins to burn before separation, is not new. It goes back to the Soviet N1 rocket, but SpaceX revived it and improved it. Now Glacier 1 uses the same method. The second stage blends different inspirations together. Its long shape, pointed tip, and large flaps make it look like New Glenn, Vulcan, and Ariane 6. This design suggests that the rocket is designed to carry long or large payloads into space. Glacier 1 is about 5 meters wide. This rocket is larger than the Falcon 9, but smaller than Starship. The company hasn't shared the rocket's height, but from images and rough estimates, the first stage appears to be about 50 meters tall, with the second stage extending another 30 meters. Taking into account the hot staging assist section, the total height is likely to be over 80 meters. Images indicate that the second stage of the Glacier 1 will have a single engine, while the first stage may have 7 to 9 engines, similar to the Falcon 9. The rocket is said to be capable of carrying 40 tons into space. It is made of stainless steel, has advanced stages, and is reusable. This means it could be launched for just tens of thousands of yuan per kilogram. On paper, this looks like a close competition. Can Chinese companies compete with SpaceX? By avoiding trial and error, they are moving forward quickly. A copy is never exactly like the original. Without SpaceX's knowledge, facilities, and years of testing, it's hard to imagine how they could achieve the same level of performance, reliability, or innovation.
Meanwhile, SpaceX continues to move forward. By the time Mammoth 1 and Glacier 1 are unveiled in 2026, Starship V3, powered by Raptor 3 engines, will likely be in the air. The difference will only grow as SpaceX accelerates its work. China's actions demonstrate its growing ambitions and SpaceX's global influence. Even if Glacier 1 never goes to space, it still demonstrates how SpaceX has transformed the industry. What do you think? Can these clones compete with SpaceX, or will SpaceX maintain its lead? I see these clones as having big goals, but they face some significant challenges ahead. Let's start with the Raptor 3 engines. As I said before, the Raptor 3 is SpaceX's best and most powerful version yet. At first glance, it looks simple, but there's a wealth of advanced technology behind that simplicity that only SpaceX knows how to master. Achieving this goal didn't happen overnight. SpaceX went through a long and difficult journey of trying things out, making mistakes, and getting better. They went from the complex and less efficient Raptor 1 to the simpler and better Raptor 2, and then to the highly sophisticated Raptor 3. Each step required years of learning, extensive testing, and continuous improvement. This journey involved simplification, eliminating waste, and adding new solutions. China, on the other hand, tried to bypass this entire process by directly copying the Raptor 3. They didn't spend years on development and testing like SpaceX did. This raises an important question. Do they truly understand the technology they're copying? Copying is one thing, but truly understanding the technology behind it is another. Without a clear understanding, failure can and likely will occur. When failure does occur, private Chinese companies may struggle to recover and could quickly disappear from the market. The problems don't end with the engines. These rockets have several major issues. The biggest issue is their design. Chinese developers often combine features from different rockets into one. They believe that the best rocket is the one that combines the best designs from around the world. However, this method has its problems. The best rocket is one that balances all its parts so they work well together, even if some parts are simple. On the other hand, combining high-quality designs that don't work well together can lead to problems and errors. If we look at the Glacier 1 rocket, we can see that the design looks uneven because the second stage is too long. To manage this stage well, the boosters need to be 60 to 70 meters tall to maintain control of thrust. Changing the second stage like this suggests that the designers may have focused too much on increasing payload capacity and not enough on stability and control. Another problem is the location of the grip bins. They are located too close to the hot staging area.
Hot staging generates a lot of energy, and because the fins are so tightly packed, they can be damaged in flight. This raises questions about the rocket's reusability, which is crucial if it is to compete with SpaceX. At first glance, this rocket and its engines may seem like a refined version of SpaceX's technology. However, the problem becomes clear upon closer inspection. In reality, the apparent perfection is only superficial. A closer look reveals that this copy pales in comparison to the robust engineering, years of refinement, and proven performance of SpaceX's systems. Ultimately, it's clear that, despite its strong desire to succeed, this copy won't be able to outdo SpaceX. The company is moving forward with confidence. Its Falcon rockets lead the global market due to their exceptional reliability and reusability. The Falcon 9 and Heavy continue to set records for rapid launch, landing, and reusability. Their performance is expected to improve further in the coming years. A new chapter is now underway with Starship, which uses the more user-friendly Raptor 3 engines. The goal of the V3 era is to reach orbit, handle complex missions, and help humans explore the Moon, Mars, and other places in space. Later this year and into next, SpaceX will have the opportunity to showcase its new ideas as competition in space intensifies. The competition is now not just between countries or businesses, but also between original products and their imitations. SpaceX has a reliable system that is constantly being improved, giving it a clear advantage. Unless something surprising happens, SpaceX will maintain its lead. The increasingly fierce competition makes this race exciting to watch. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you all for your support.